Hi, good morning, everyone. So, extra possession. In the last class, we have discussed the chapter number 8, that is the various Java operators, that is the Java operations that we perform with the various operators. Now, today I'm going to continue with the new topic, new chapter, that is chapter number 9, that is what are the various loops that is available in the Java. Chapter number 9 is the Java loop control. As you have already discussed in the C and the C++, there are multiple looping that is available, like there is a for statement, while, do while. In the same way, there are multiple loops that is available in the Java programming also. So let's start with the chapter number 9, just basic of the looping, that is what is a looping, what is iteration, how the looping will be done, then go for the difference between the while loop and the do while loop. So let's start the session. Now, first thing is that, any doubt, anyone? Okay, so let's start the session. So, this is the chapter number 9, that is what are the various Java loop controls. So, first of all, what is a looping? So, for example, if I am going to execute the same block of the code again and again, that is known as a looping. So, we can say that it is an iteration. Iteration means a multiple levels or multiple steps that is performed again and again, that is known as a loop. For example, if I am performing or if I am doing the calculation, that is addition of the 2 plus 5, again. That is for the 10 times, that is done by the looping in the programming language. Only one time I have to write the code, then I have to write the syntax for the one time and it will be repeated for the 9 times. But if I am doing it in a manual way, for example, I have to write for the 10 times, 2 plus 10, 2 into 10, whatever the solution, whatever the scenario, whatever the input that we are giving. So this provides a portability that we are not going to write 10 times, but we are writing only one time and that will be available in the 10 times. So that concept is known as a looping. So in simple terms, iteration, multiple occurrences, that is known as a looping. So this gives a definition that is available. There are many situations or the scenario when we need to execute a block of the code multiple number of or n number of times, and that is known as a looping. So whenever we need to execute a block of the code means a group of the code, n number of times or multiple times, that is known as the looping. These are the various looping mechanisms. In this, there are three loops in Java. First one is a while loop, then there is a do while loop, then there is a for loop. It depends on the programming to programming. In C++, there are multiple, maybe these three loops, again, we can say the switch statement, but switch statement is not available over here. So it depends on the programming language. What are the various looping that is available in the Java? What are the various programming language, what are the various looping concept that is available in the programming language. So let's start with the first loop, that is a while loop. My first question is to all of you, first of all, what is the main difference between the while loop and the do while loop as I studied in the C and the C++? My question is, what is the main difference between the while and the do while loop? Remember about the C, that is a procedure programming module, C++, that is an object-oriented module. So, refresh your memory and tell me the answer, what is the main difference between the while and the do while loop. Take for some time, take 2 minutes, 5 minutes, but you have to answer. So, the first part that is available is the while loop, that is a while looping will be done to perform the operation. So, while loop is a control structure, there are multiple structures that is available in the programming. It is a part of the control structure that allows you to repeat a task to a certain number of times. That means, for example, if I want to repeat the task n number of times, a certain number of times, that is done by the while loop. So, what is the syntax of a while loop? This is the syntax that is available. It is a control structure that allows you to repeat a task on a certain number of times. And what is the syntax of a while loop? That is a while, that is a Boolean expression. Boolean expression means the condition or the statement, whatever the condition we are going to give. That is a Boolean expression, then there are statements. The statements may be n number of statements which we want to print. That is a statement. So first one is, first part is a while, that is a keyword that is fixed over here. Then there is a Boolean expression. Then there is a curly braces. After the curly braces, there are the multiple statements, whatever the statement that we want to print. And when executing, if the Boolean expression result is true, then the actions inside the loop will be executed. So you can take the condition. That is included in the loop will be executed over here. this will continue as long as expression result is true. For example, if the condition is becomes the 4, for example, I give the condition as a 3 is greater than 4. That is not true. Or if we can say that A is less than 10, or A is, yeah, less than 10, not equals to less than 10. So it will go for the 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Not 10, till 9. So there are 10 iteration that will be executed. This will be come out, or we can say this will continue as long as the expression's result is true. This is one of the syntax of the while loop. While Boolean expression, then there are multiple statements. Whatever statement, that may be a printer statement, there may be a cout statement, any statement that is executed. Here, the key point of the while loop is that loop might not run or might not ever run. When the expression is tested and the result is false, the loop would be skipped or will be escaped, and the first statement after the while loop will be executed. So whatever the first statement that is executed after the while loop will be executed. Now this is one of the example that is public class test. The same example, that is a test is a class that is of the public type. Then there is the same line, that is public static void mainstream args. Now there is a declaration of the variable that is int x equals to 10. Now we are initializing the value of the x by the 10, or we can say we store the value of the 10 into the x. Now there is a while loop that runs for the 20 times, or we can say 19 times, because it starts with the 0, it ends with the 19. It is not equals to 20, it is a less than 20. So less than 20 means it will not go up to the 20, but it will go up to the 19, because the symbol that is available is less than 20. If it is available as a less than equals to 20, that means including the 20 also. But in this case, there is no 20 that is included. And it starts with that 10 because it is a value that is given in the, or we are initializing the variable that is x equals to 10. So this will run 10 for the 9 times, that is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So it will run for the 9 times. So this is one of the best example of the while loop. That is, first of all, we are giving the initializing the value of the x by the 10. Then there is a while loop that runs for the 9 times, because the syntax is that while x is less than 20, that means 10 is less than 20. So it will run for the 10, it will run for the 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Next line is the statement of the while loop. So this syntax is over here, like the statements. Now this is one of the first statement that is used. This is system.out.print value of the x. So whatever the output, whatever the syntax, whatever the statement we are giving in the double quote, that will print as it is. So it will print as it is, that is the value of the x is. Then for printing the variable value, we are using in Java, we are using as a plus x. But in the C and the C++, there is no requirement of using the plus for the variable, but in the Java it is mandatory to use the plus sign for the variable. So this is value of the x is then plus x. In the next line, this is also a statement, x will be incremented by 1. So Larry, can you tell me how it is incremented by 1? This is mentioned x plus plus. So how do I know it is incremented by 1? I'm not saying that it is incremented by 2. Why? Okay. Yes, because it is equals to that x equals to x plus 1. That means it will automatically increment it by 1. As we have studied in the last chapter, that is the various operators, we have studied about what is the meaning of the plus plus and the plus plus x. So one is a post, one is a pre. It is one of the example of the post. Why? Because it is available at the right hand side. So that means x plus plus means x is equals to the x plus 1. So it will increment the value of the x by 1. Next is system.out.print backward slash. So it will go to the next line, because this is the backspace character, so we can say the escape sequence character that is available, that is a backward slash. Then there is one curly brace close for this while loop, the next curly brace close for this public static void main args, the next curly brace will be closed for the main class. So three curly braces will be open and three curly braces will be closed. This is, please remember, if you open five curly braces, like while we are interested in the video. So it will close, otherwise error will be occurred. That may be a syntax error, that may be a logical error. Now, what is the output for this one? First of all, it will use for the, or it will go for the 10. Now, look, 10 is less than 20. Condition is true. Why? Because 10 value is less than the 20 value. So condition is true, it will print the value of the x. Now, in this case, the value of the x is 10. It will print it. Now, next is 10 plus, that is a 10 plus 1 is 11. Now, x value becomes 11. Now, check for the condition 11. 11 is less than 20. Yeah, condition is true. 11 is less than, or 11 value is less than the 20 value. Now, again, it will print the value. What is the value of x right now? That is 11. In the next slide, it will again incremented by 1. Now 11 becomes 12, that is 12 is less than 20. Again, the 12 value is less than the 20 value. Again, the condition is true, it will print it. Next, x plus plus, that becomes 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. For example, when it becomes 19, it will print the 19 value. Okay. Now, it will be incremented by 1, that is x plus plus. So 19 plus 1 is 20. Now, check for the condition. 20 is less than 20. This condition is not true. Why? Because 20 is equals to 20, but 20 is not less than 20, right? So this condition is false. Now over here, the loop will terminate. Why? Because loop will execute till the condition is true. So the condition is false, the loop will terminate. So loop will terminate at the value of the 20, and it will print the value, or it will run from the 10 to the 19. Now let's see the output. This is for the one first case, that is the x, then 11, then 12, then 13, then 14, then 15, 16, 17, 18, and 19. It will terminate for the 20 by it. The condition is given is 20 is less than 20. But 20 is equals to 20, not less than 20. So this program is clear to each and everyone. This is known as try run. That means go for the looping, check for the condition, check for the scenarios. So shall I repeat again, because this is one of the first program of the looping. So shall I repeat again? Okay. So let's start with the basics. First word that is given, or the first line that is given, is the public class test. That means we are initializing, or we are declaring the one of the class, the class name is the test. Then there's the curly brace that is opened. Next line will be the same, that is public static void main string args. That is okay, the same line, there is no issue over here. Now after this, there again the curly brace that will be started. Now initializing the value of the x, and I will take any of the variable, that may be x, that may be a, that may be a b. In this example, it is taking the variable as a x, that is x equals to 10. That means initializing the value of the 10 into the a. Remember, whatever the value that is given on the right hand side, that will put into the left hand side. Now right hand side is given as a 10, and the left hand side is x. So 10 value is put into the x, right? And it always terminates with a semicolon. Then there is a while loop, that is while x is less than 20. This is the place, this is the line where the looping comes in the picture. That is, take the while loop, that is while x is less than 20. So check for the condition. Now remember, condition always represented or carried out within the parenthesis. This is the bracket. In the programming, it is known as the parenthesis. And this is x is less than 20. Again, parenthesis will be closed because it is open, so it is closed. Then there is a curly braces. Within the curly braces, there are multiple statements we can write. The first statement that is available over here is system.out.print. That means system.out.print means we are printing on the screen, we are printing on the NetBeans, we are printing on the JavaBeans, we are printing on the Windows. That is the value of x. So whatever the value, whatever the statement that is available in the double quotes, that will print as it is. Then for showing the value of the variable, we are using the plus, then there is a variable name. Then this statement is also finished out, so it will be terminated by the semicolon. Then there is x plus plus, that means the value of the x is incremented by 1. That is, x plus plus means x equals to x plus 1. Then there is a system.out. Again, x plus plus, the statement is over, it is terminated by semicolon. So that means when the statement is over, we have done with the task, so the next statement will be terminated by the semicolon. Next part is system.out.print \n. This is the escape sequence character, that means printing in the next line. So each and every value is printing in the next line, because we are giving the statement, we are giving the one of the escape sequence character, that is \n, that means moving into the next line automatically. This will also terminate with a semicolon. Then there is one curly brace close, that is for the while loop. Another curly brace close, that is for the public, static, void, main, here she is. Next curly brace will be closed for the class, that is the class test. Okay, so this is one of the example. Now let's see how it will execute, that means dry run. So first is x is less than 20. X is less than 20 means taking out first of all what is the value of the x at the initial stage. We are initializing the value of the x by the 10, so take out the first value, that is a 10. Check for the condition, 10 is less than 20, yeah, condition is true. Because 10 is less than the 20, when we see the series from 1 to 20, 10 is less than 20 as per the digits, as per the mass rule. So condition is true. So it will go inside. Inside there is a value that is printing out x value. Now the x value is the 10. It will print the value of the x is 10. Not only the value, but it is written over here, that is the value of x is plus x, that means a 10. Then increment the value of the x. Now the x becomes 11. Then go to the next line. Within the next line, again going for the condition. Now x becomes 11. 11 is less than 20. Again condition is true, because 11 value, 11 digit is less than the 20. Then go to the next line, that is the value of x. That value becomes now 11, so it will print the value as 11. Then x plus plus, that is again that becomes 12, because 11 plus 1 is 12. Again go for the condition, 12 is less than 20, yeah, condition is true, because 12 digit is less than the 20 digit. So again it will go to the next line, print the value of the 12. Again go for the 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I am skipping this one because this will lengthy procedure, but your concept is clear, that it will execute automatically in your mind as well as in the program. Now for example, it will becomes 19. Check the condition, 19 is less than 20, yeah, condition is true, 19 value is less than the 20 value, so it will print, that is the value of the x is 19. Then x plus plus, now x becomes 20, because 19 plus 1 is 20. So it will go for the looping. Now check for the condition, 20 is less than 20. No, condition is not true. Why? Because 20 is equals to 20, not less than 20. Then go for the next line, that is the value of x. Why it is going for the next line? It is not going into the next line. Why? Because the loop will terminate, and it will terminate and go out beyond the curly braces. Now the loop will terminate and the values of the x will print it from the 10 to the 19, that is the 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. This is one of the best example of the while loop, how the while loop works. Remember about the main syntax of the while loop, that is a while, then there is a condition, then within the curly braces there are multiple statements. Okay. So look over this program. Again, if there's any doubts, you can ask the doubts from me. Look over this program. So let's continue with the next looping, that is a do while loop. Remember, while is an entry control loop. Why it is an entry control loop? Because we are checking the condition at the time of the entry. What is the syntax? While, then there is a condition, then after the condition there are multiple statements. That means we are checking the condition at the time of the entry. That's why it is known as an entry control loop. Now next part is a do while loop, that is an exit control loop. Why it is known as exit? Just reverse of the while. In the while, we are checking the condition at the starting phase. But in the do while, we are checking the condition at the end of the phase, or at the end of the looping. That's why it is known as exit control loop. So one is the entry control loop, one is the exit control loop. Now, this is explanation of this do while loop, that is very similar to the while loop, except that do while is guaranteed to execute at least once. Now, this is one of the important line. It will execute at least one time. Why it is executed at least one time? The main reason is that the condition is checked at the end of the program, at the end of the looping. So it must be executed at least one time. Even though the condition is false, it will execute for one time. Because condition is checked at the end of the program. This is the syntax of do while loop. Do, there is a curly braces, then statements. After the curly braces, after the statement, the curly brace will be closed. Then there is a while loop after closing of the curly brace. Then there is a Boolean expression after the curly brace will be closed. So see over here, at this stage, at least one time execution is available. After this curly brace, there is a condition that will check afterwards. So that means do while loop execute at least one, then at last, or then afterward, the condition will be checked. That is do statements while Boolean expression. Notice that the Boolean expression appears at the end of the loop. So the statements in the loop execute once before the Boolean is tested. The same as I explained to you, that it will execute at least one because the condition is checked after the curly brace will be closed. Now if the Boolean expression is true, the flow of the control jump back to do. And the statement in the loop executes again. This process repeats until the Boolean expression is false. The same line. That means either the condition is checked on the at the top of the program or at the bottom of the program, but the rule is same. It will execute till the condition is true. Then the public, then there is a class test. The same example. So this is one of the example of the do while loop. So there's the public class test, then public static void as in arg. Then in typing the value of the x give it the 10, that is int x equals to 10, then use the do while to system.out.println. So that is the value of the x between that is 10, then x plus plus. It will go to the 11, then check the condition. 11 is less than 20, a condition is true, then it will execute. Then again go for the do loop or the do statement. Then check for the condition of 11, then there is 12, it will go, then 13, 14, again it will execute till 19. Now, for example, if the value of the x over here is 20, it will execute or it will print the value of the 20. Why? Because it will execute without checking the condition in first three lines. So it will give the value as a 20, that is the value of the x is 20. Then 20 plus, 20 plus plus, then it will go for the check the condition. That is 21 is less than 20, again the condition is false, so it will terminate the loop. It will print at least one time even though the condition is false. That is x is less than 20 or x is less than 30 and any value, but it will execute at least one time. So this will execute at least one time, then the condition will be executed. This is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Then there is a for loop, that is a repetition control structure that allows you to efficiently write a loop that needs to execute a specific number of times. Then it is while. So while and the do while loop will be over. While is an entry control loop, that means we are checking the condition at the time of the entry. Then do while is an exit control loop, it will check the condition at the time of the exit. And the limitation of the do while loop is that it will execute at least one time, or it will print the output at least one time even though the input is correct. But even though the condition is false, it will execute at least one time. But in case of the do while loop, in case of the while loop, it will not execute at least one time or at most one time because the condition is checked at the time of the entry. Okay. Now the next loop is the for loop. So while and the do while is over. For loop is a repetition control structure that allows you to efficiently write a loop that needs to execute a specific number of times. So whatever the number of times it will execute it, so it will efficiently write a loop that need to execute a specific number of times. And a for loop is useful when you know how many times a task is to be repeated. That is, how many times it will repeat, how many steps it will repeat. That is a for loop. So if I know in advance it will repeat for the 5 times, this will be very beneficial looping. Now, what is the syntax of the for loop? That is a for, then there is the initialization, then there is a Boolean expression, that means a condition, then there is an update. Update means either the increment or decrement. So this is one of the syntax of the for loop, and each and every value, each and every part is terminated by the semicolon. This is one semicolon, then this is next semicolon. For initialization, that is, for example, the previous example, we are declaring the value of the x as a 10. So in this, we have to write int x equals to 10. Then what is the condition in the previous example? That is, x is less than 20. This is the condition that is available. So we have to write this condition over here in the Boolean expression, that is x is less than 20. Then there is an update. That may be x plus plus, that may be x minus minus. So this is the update, that is x plus plus. So we have to write over here, that is x plus plus. So as per the previous example, this is int x equals to 10, then x is less than 20, then x plus plus. And this is again the curly brace, this is again the closing curly brace, and these are the various statements. What are the statements that we are including? The multiple statements are available in the for loop. One of the main important concept for the for loop is that it will not terminate with the semicolon. That means we are not using the semicolon in the, we are not using the semicolon for the termination in the for loop, but semicolons will be used for separating these parts, that is the initialization, then there is a Boolean expression, then there is an update. Update means increment or decrement. These are the few steps, that is how the flow of the control will be used in the for loop. So first part is initialization step is executed first and only once. This step allows you to declare and initialize any loop control variable. So initialization step is executed first and only once. That means we are initializing the value only once in a for loop. And this step allows you to declare and initialize any loop control variable. So we are initialize any loop control variable, that may be a x, that may be a y, that may be a, b, any loop variables. So the initialization step is executed first and only once, and this step allows you to declare and initialize any loop control variable. You are not required to put a statement over here as long as the semicolon appears. So you are not supposed to put an initialization over. Initialization step is executed first and only once at the time of the looping, in the time lifetime of the looping, and this step allows you to declare and initialize any loop control variables. Whatever the loop variable that is required, and you are requested to put the statement over here as long as semicolon appears. So we are also initializing the variable with the data type over here, that is int x equals to 10. Not the x equals to 10, but int x equals to 10 is also okay because the statement that is available and that is also terminated with the semicolon. Next, the Boolean expression is evaluated, that is the Boolean expression. If the condition is true, the body of the loop will be executed. And if the condition is false, then the body of the loop does not execute and the flow of the control jump to the next statement that is used for the for loop. So if it is available or if it is a false, that means it is not true, then the body of the loop, whatever the body of the statement that will be available, that does not execute and the flow of the control jump to the next statement, whatever the next statement that is available that is passed for the loop. Next, after the body of the for loop executes, the flow of the control jump back to the update statement. There's an update statement that is also available after the semicolon, that is either increment or the decrement. One of the example is x plus plus, that means value of the x is incremented by 1. And this statement allows you to update any loop control variables. We can also put the statement or put this update statement as a blank if there is no increment or the decrement in the looping. So as per the example of the previous, or as per the previous example, this is the initialization part, that is int x equals to 10, then there is a semicolon, then this is the condition, that is x is less than 20, but the while loop is not available or not coming over here, because this is already a loop. So the condition is over here is x is less than 20. Then next one is the update, that is x plus plus, that is this case, that is x plus plus. So Boolean expression is now evaluated again, and if it is true, the loop executes and the process repeats for n number of times, whatever the situations. In this case, it will execute for the 10 times. Sorry, for the 9 times, because it is available with that 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. And after the Boolean expression is false, the for loop will terminate. So when the condition is becomes false, the loop will terminate automatically, as we see in the while and the do while loop. This is the next example, that is of the for loop. Now look the difference between the while and the do while, for and the do while. This is lengthy program and this is only one line program, because everything is available within the one line. That is public class test. The same class will be declared. The class name is the test. Then there is a curly braces. Public static void main string args. Again there is a curly braces. Now this is the for loop. You have to understand this concept, because these two lines are same in each and every program. There is a for loop. Within the for loop there is a parenthesis. This is bracket is known as a parenthesis. Then int x equals to 10. We are declaring the, or we are initializing the value, initializing the variable. That means int x is of the int type, so it takes 2 bytes in the memory, that is x equals to 10. Now it will terminate with a semicolon. X is less than 20. Now what is the Boolean expression? What is the statement condition that is available? That is x is less than 20. Then again it will terminate it by the semicolon. Then x equals to x plus 1, that means x plus plus, that is a update. So each and every time it will be incremented by 1. Next line is system.out.println or printed, then value of the x. It will print as it is. Why? Because it is available in the double quotes. Then plus x. It will show the variable value. For example, in first case, it is 10. In the next case, it is 11. Now let's see how it will execute. Let's take a dry run for this program. For example, in the first case, it is available as x equals to. So it is used as x equals to 10. That means the first value that is available is 10. So it is showing over here, that is 10, first of all, because there is no increment, no decrement. The condition is true. That is 10 is less than 20. Yeah, condition is true. It will print for the value 10. Then it will go for the increment in the next iteration, in the next looping. Now the 10 becomes 11. Why? 10 plus 1 is 11. Then 11 is less than 20, a condition is also true, that it will, then it will go for the next statement, that is 11 is less than 20, a condition is true, so it will print the value of the x, that is a 11, then go for the x plus 1, that then the value becomes 12, 12 is less than 20, again the condition is true, it will print for the 12, then 13 is also true, print 13, 14 is also true, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Now 19 is less than 20, yeah, condition is true. 19 digit is less than the 20 digit, so print the value as a 19. Then 19 plus 1 is 20. Now 20 is less than 20, condition is false. Why? Because 20 is equal to the 20. Now it will not terminate, it will not execute, but it terminates over the 20 value. So it will execute only for the 10 values, that is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So these are the three basics, the looping that we have done. One is a while loop, next is a do while loop, next is a for loop. Next is, the next topic that is available is the enhanced for loop in the Java. That means the advanced part of the for loop in the Java. This is the syntax, that is for, then there is a parenthesis, declaration, then there is a colon, then there is an expression. Within the for, there will be a curly brace, the same pattern, then there are multiple statements, then the curly, close. So what is the syntax? For declaration, then there is a colon, and then there is an expression. Now what is the meaning of the declaration? This is a newly declared block variable. Whatever the newly declared block variable, which of the type compatible with the elements of the array you are accessing, and the variables will be available within for the for flow, and its value will be same for the current array element. That is the declaration means the declaring the value, initializing the value. Then there is the expressions, that is like the condition, like a Boolean expression, whatever the Boolean expression we are using, that will gives the value that will evaluate through the array you need to loop through. That may be array variable, that may be a method variable, any variable we are using in this one. This is one of the example of the new for loop, or we can say the advanced for loop that is used in the Java language. So this is public class test. Then public static void mean that these two lines are same. Then within this public static void mean, these are the two declarations. So this is one of the declaration, that is an array will be declared of the int type that contains five values, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So there are five values in this array. Use the for loop, this is the declaration, and this is the expression. What is expression? That is an array. Now system.out.print, then there is an x value. It will be printed. What are these x values? First x value is 10, next x value is 20, then 30, 40, 50. Because there are five values that is used in the array. Then system.out.print x, then system.out.print, then there is a commas. So why this is given as a comma? Because each value is separated by the comma separator. Then go for the next line, use the escape sequence character, that is system.out.print, then escape sequence character, that is slash n or backward slash n. Then declare the string as a string name, James, Larry, Tom, Lacey. Again using the for loop, now it is showing the string name, that is a declaration. We are declaring the value, or we are declaring the string as a name. Then names, that is an array, system.out.print name, then system.out.print comma. So it will be available as a 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 in the one line. Why? Because it is available in the looping. So it is available in the array, that means number, that is starts with a 10 and ends with a 50, that is 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. Next one is names, that is James, Larry, Tom, and Lacey. Next part is the break keyword. So break keyword is used to stop the entire looping. So if I want to break the, or if I want to stop the looping, because for example, I think that this condition is not true, this condition is not valid in the program. So I have to break the program, I have to break the looping. That breaking of the looping is done by the break keyword. And the break keyword must be, or can be used inside loop or a switch statement. This is one of the syntax. Only the break keyword will be available, and there is a semicolon. This is the break. Now the keyword or the looping will be controlled, or looping will be stopped. And next one is the continue keyword. So we have done with the basics or the main looping. Now these are the various keywords that is left over. One of the keyword is the break, that is used to break the loop. Next is the continue, that can be used in any of the loop control structures, and it causes the loop to intermediately jump to the next iteration. That means skipping all the statement that is after the continue statement and move to the next part, next block, that is done by the continue. It is used in the for loop to intermediate or immediately jump to the update statement. It is used in the while and the do while loop to jump to the Boolean expression. This is the syntax, the continue word will be used. Then again the same syntax, x is 10, then continue for this one.